I'm Niharika. I'm a GIS person from TRAC. TRAC is Telangana State Remote Sensing Application Center, and ours is the nodal agency for Telangana State applications here, remote sensing applications here. We have various divisions, land resources, water resources, infrastructure mapping, web applications, and other divisions here. And under these divisions, we carry on various GIS and remote sensing based projects. Coming to road information systems, if you take, this is under infrastructure division, we carry out this application. Here we have mapped all the roads in Telangana state with the help of Panchayat Raj division. Help of Panchayat Raj division, where we have mapped each and every gram panchayat in the state, and also habitation information. And we have seen the connectivity of roads to each and every GP. Road surface information is available, how much of BT road is there, how much of CC road is there in the entire state. And under agricultural department, we actually take every fortnight report for drought information here, where NDVI and NDWI, these kind of remote sensing applications are done. And then we have cadastral information of the state, entire state of Telangana. Cadastral information, we have taken this from land resources division, where the old maps, cloth maps, were actually taken. They were scanned, and then they were digitized, and that information is spatially represented here with the help of GIS applications. So like that, we are also working on drone now. Drone sat image is also taken, and then mapping is being done. That is a small pilot project we have just started. Under urban applications, we have done this nala and tank encroachment. If you can see the image here, initially in 1970s this was a tank, and now if you see, there is completely urbanized. It's all illegal encroachment that is happening. Even the nala also, you can see all this illegal encroachment here. If you see these tanks now, how was it in 2000 and how was it now in 2018? It's completely encroached. So these are the herbal applications we are taking forward. And then this is groundwater recharge. Okay. And where with the help of geological information, we have mapped all these things.
My name is Sadhana Reddy. I'm working in Telangana State Remote Sensing Application Center. I'm in geoscience division as a scientific assistant. I'm explaining about these projects. This is demarcation of MLPL mining blocks using DGPS and total station survey and georeferencing with cadastral maps. Basically, we take the points from Department of Mines and Geology. We will take the DGPS points from release boundary points from ground position, and we plot on the by using the total station, we get the points. From there we will plot on the ArcGIS software, and we will georeferencing with the cadastral level. Like this we will show the each transition point and each lease owners. Like this, when they are alerted the lease owners, like this red color. Now in ground position, like this, how much area they are encroaching, how much taking the mine, how much, like that. And we will import on the web portal. This is one project. Another project, this is the NMDT fund, which are funded by the Department of Mines and Geology with the central government. For this, first we will give the points where how much exploration is there, like for the blocks are G4 exploration, G3 exploration for boreholes. First we plot on the take the points, then we will plot on the topo sheet location map and geological map. This is we will take from the Geological Survey of India this map. In that we will plot which stone is there, which mine is there. Especially this exploration is going for limestone. Then how much exploration, like G4, G3, boreholes, like 400 by 400, like that. Next, we will geologically rocks we will identify, we will layout preparation. Then how much calcium oxide is there, how much silica oxide is there in this block, how much quantity it will come, like that.